Good evening, I'm Mia Gradney. Here at 39 News, we work hard around the clock to make sure you are getting the very latest and the news that impacts your life. But our newscast wouldn't be possible without the men and women on the front lines bringing you those images, our photographers. So tonight we're paying tribute to them by giving you a look at life on the other side of the lens, through the viewfinder. And we want to start with photographer Mike Barbagallo, who had a front row seat to history. Mike was in New York on September 11th at Ground Zero when the second plane hit. He and photographer Shannon Runnan recently won an Emmy for this piece, in which Mike describes what he saw and felt while trying to bring you those pictures none of us will forget. Here's their story, 9/11 Behind the Lens.
I've lived all my life in New York, and I always saw the towers, and I always thought they'd always be there, buildings that would stand the test of time. As a kid, the towers were always prevalent in the skyline, and definitely caught the eye of any child growing up in New York City. You could see them from every direction, everywhere around the city, whether you're from Jersey or Brooklyn. The towers are always there. To me, they were indestructible.
Mike, we're gonna get killed!
I could hear him getting excited at times.
Mike!
I took the camera, I ran towards the tower, literally right across the street from it, and I started to roll. I was trying my best to concentrate and get my shots. I was kind of living my life through the viewfinder at that point. People were just confused, didn't know what was going on, scared, frightened. I really didn't get a sense as to what was going on yet. I couldn't see what was coming until I see this huge jet speeding towards the tower. It hits. That moment lasted split seconds, really, but to me it lasted an eternity. I knew I was watching history. History was unfolding in front of me.
And it was like a ball of flame so big I couldn't believe it. Actually, you felt it in your face.
People just cannot believe what they just witnessed. At this point, it's just mass confusion and pandemonium. It was hard to breathe. At that point, it hit me, and I realized the severity of what I was seeing. What I was seeing and what I was videotaping was something that was going to be seen forever. My reaction was to videotape it. I was trying my best to document the moment.
Did I see it? No, I was supposed to be on the 82nd floor for a 9 o'clock meeting, and I was about 10 minutes late to get there.
We have a lot of dead American people up here, and we need answers.
To see an event like this unfolding in front of your eyes, it's amazing, it's life changing. And I'm gonna be talking about this for the rest of my life.